All right, Supriya, great job on the piano. Really starting to get those rhythms down. Remember, the thing we're thinking about is we're going to have our thumb on C right there, and then our pinky on G. And we're going to do some different things there. The first thing to think about is that the note with a big hole like that is going to be four counts. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now, if you see one with a hole, but it has a little stem coming off of it, that's going to be one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And then if it's colored in, if it's a black note with the notes coming up, it's going to be the fastest one, which is quarter notes. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right, so now here are the first couple lines on your first page there. So we have one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Now I'm going to do that one again. Let's repeat that. This is the top one. Ready, go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay, I think you got that one pretty easily. This one's a little bit trickier. The next one down is doing them all at the same time right off the bat. One, two, three, four. Then it splits it. C for two, G for two, then the together again, and then hold the G. C, here it is again. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Together. Two, three, four. G, then C. A couple more. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Together. Two, three, four. G and C. All right. And the other thing that you were doing so well was also getting our fingers, right, to just go up and play one finger per key. And even though we haven't quite got to the left hand yet, I would say also do that down here, and then you've got your pinky starting it. But then do the same thing you were doing during lessons, which is try to keep those fingers curved, right? If they're flat, you might run into this problem, right? You might accidentally hit some other keys, which we don't want. We want to make sure we're keeping our fingers as thin as they can be and just curve them as you go up and down the scale. Okay, there you go. Good luck.